Good morning, dear listeners, and welcome to another edition of Press Review. It is October 14, 2020. Today, we start this edition with the Mutation newspaper, which talks of the mayor of Yaoundé 7, Augustine Tamba, and his reasons for being a candidate in the upcoming municipal council elections. Read more on page 8 and 9. Its page 5 also talks of the central hospital in Yaoundé and the theft of a baby. Le Quotidien newspaper talks of the neutralization of a great terrorist in the Lebialem division in the southwest region. We move straight to the Daily Cameroon Tribune newspaper, which tells us about the sale of modernity in its page 2 to 5. It also talks of the higher education sector and how universities are prepared to open their doors come tomorrow, October 15, 2020. L'Economie talks of the Port Authority of Douala and its new engines in its page 3. On the taxis, place and telephones, the paper explains that the clarification about the law can convince the customs. Page 2 has the story. The Daily English Guardian Post gives us details about the Prime Minister who hails innovative Port Authority's management. It says the board chair, Shay Jones Yembe, says Port Authority of Douala is measured drive of Cameroon's emergency by 2035. Page 5 to 7 holds more details. We can also read about how the government spends over 20 billion francs CFA annually on fixtures rent. Content is found on page 2. Quotidien Emergence talks of the Presbyterian Church in Cameroon and drama in the Mendong Parish in its page 9. We can also read about Victor Mbarika, who states that he wants to train researchers that can really help the government of Cameroon. Page 10 has the details for this article. Le Quotidien Réalité talks of the killing of a separatist general by the name of General Ayeke and how his corpse have been paraded all over the streets of Kumba. Page 10 to 11 has the details for this story. The story of Dr. Nka Golov, who is a young Cameroonian economic operator, has convinced Indians with the creation of three big enterprises in India. Page 6 to 9 holds more details. Dias Passant talks of the law and taxes on telephone and what to understand about the tax in its page 4. We can also read about the Anglophone crisis provided in page 11. We end this edition with Esigang, which talks of the Shan and Khan games as Ferdinand Gongo and Manauda Malachi, the Minister of Public Health, are slacking with the President of the Republic of Cameroon, Paul Biya. Ladies and gentlemen, that is what the papers had for us today. Please get the papers and read these interesting stories, and do not forget to follow our social media handles and our website www.refletdafriquetv.com for more updates.